The concern of non-nationals being issued Ugandan passports and national identification cards was brought to the attention of the Committee of Defense and Internal Affairs by Gilbert Olanya, the MP Clark South, during their meeting with officials from the National Citizenship and Immigration Directorate.
By law, non-citizens is not supposed to have our passports. But right now, Mr. Chairman, very many non-Ugandans who are having our passports, and they are very comfortable. So I don't know why and how they are accessing our passports. The case in point, our very many South Sudanese, we are staying together with them, and they are having Ugandan passports. So I don't know how and why you give our passports to non-citizens.
They had appeared before the committee to defend the 2024-2025 national budget. Olanya noted that it's a disappointment to find common people holding diplomatic passports colored red, which are meant for government ministers and their wives, foreign service officers and their wives and children below the age of 16, staying with them abroad, the head of the civil service, the chief justice, judges of the High Court and the Court of Appeal, and justices of the Supreme Court, the Vice Chancellor Makerere University, and the Governor Bank of Uganda.
By the summer, who is not working is bearing the diplomatic passport with red cover. Members of parliament are having data type. So I don't know the criteria you normally use in giving passports to Ugandans. The case in point, I remember I traveled to Rwanda with some Ugandans. Someone who is not doing any work, he was a cleaner somewhere, and the person is having red passport. So I was very surprised.
Members of parliament are troubled by the increased number of cases of foreigners holding Ugandan passports illegally.
Some foreigners come here, they get certificate of residence, they nationalize. At the end of the day, they end up getting the national IDs and their passport. Maybe the minister fell short to mention to you about that. And so he was holding the passport in a very legal way. These are Indians, some are from Pakistan, and many of them are acquiring passports because they have regularized.
Indians don't come from Pakistan.
I'm not saying only people from Pakistan.
Okay.
But all that is Asia.
General David Muhoozi, the Minister of State for Internal Affairs, in response, admitted that the government is aware of the numerous people holding passports that they are not entitled to, and efforts are ongoing to apprehend perpetrators.
It's true. There are some people who have got these passports to which they are not entitled. And we have sometimes people who gave out those passports in the past. But when we use every opportunity, when we red flag you, we get it back. Even IDs, by the way, no nationals have our IDs, and that's why you hear this noise. They have discriminated me. They have taken my ID, because when you bring it back for renewal, then we go back, we say, but we are not entitled to this.
Muhoozi revealed the increase of cases of Uganda misusing their passports by giving them to non-nationals, especially Nigerians, which undermines integrity of Ugandan passports.
Some of the people who have them in the right way, like especially our passports given to foreigners, I'm told the people themselves who have, you have a passport, even a blue one, then you go, you give it to a Nigerian. So how do you do it? Your own passport, you got it correctly, but I don't know what they do to them, but they remove pages and insert their names and find a Nigerian trafficking drugs in China, Ugandan passport.
In February 2024, the Ministry of Internal Affairs revealed that 97% of Ugandans don't own passports. Since 2018, when the country started issuing electronic passports, only 1.3 million of Ugandans have applied. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.